Hello, everyone. So I know it's been a while since I've done a Tip Tuesday, and for that I apologize. Things have been a little crazy, and I just haven't had time, but don't think I forgot about you. Today's Tip Tuesday has to do with cheat meals, and really it's about why you should enjoy your cheat meals, and really how to have those cheat meals without having to worry about storing fat. And so in this video, I'm going to go over two main things in terms of when to cheat and then why to cheat. So before getting into that, I want you to remember the 90-10 rule, which basically means 90% of the time your diet is under control, meaning you're looking at whole foods, you're eating lean meats, seeds, nuts, veggies, no sugar, no alcohol. And then the other 10% is when you can indulge a little bit. And when you look it up in terms of math, right, you get 3 meals a day times 7 times a week equals 21 meals within a week. So 10% of that is roughly 2.5 meals, which means 2 meals out of the full week you can afford to cheat. And that kind of comes into play when you look at people that do something called carb cycling. And basically what carb cycling has to do with is some days you have a low carb intake and other days you have a high carb intake. And realistically, the reason why you're switching those or your carb cycling is because you're trying to do two different things. A low carbs obviously has to do with fat loss, and high carbs has to do with muscle growth. And so basically in terms of when you should have your cheat days, it should rotate and align with your workout schedule. So on days like leg day, right, when you're going to use a lot of calories, right, your toughest day, that's when you want to have your cheat meal, because you're burning more calories than normal. So having that cheat meal won't necessarily super impact your results and your progress. In terms of why, and this is just my personal opinion and kind of what I found, is that it keeps your body consistent. It reminds your body, kind of almost tricks it into why eating well feels so good. Because when you have that cheat meal, it might taste great, but afterwards you notice a difference. You feel a difference in your body in terms of whether you go to the gym after you have that cheat meal or you don't, right? You go about your day and then maybe work out later. Your body feels different. You might feel a little bit more sluggish. You might feel bloated. And that feeling kind of sticks with you. And it makes you not want to have those cheat meals as much because you want to feel good. Your body now knows what it means to be healthy and what it means to look at food in terms of fueling your body. And so the why for this really just has to do with the mental part of being dedicated and consistent. And so, yeah, I hope that helps you guys. Remember, cheat meals are not the end of the world. It's kind of exciting to have something to look forward to. But you really do want to be mindful of when you have those cheat meals. Look a week ahead, plan it out so that your progress and your goals don't get impacted.